Hello guys, welcome back in Project 7X Channel. We are with Daniel Stella. He made top cut in this European Championship. You want to say something about that profile?
Yeah, I decided to play Danger Tia because it's the best deck, I think. I lost the first round of the top cut in Mirror Match just because I lost the dice roll. And Dweller is so important in this kind of matchup.
Okay.
So I will explain.
That's perfect.
I play three Nessies. They are the best dangers actually because it's aqua and you can make kit. So
yeah, of
it's
course.
It's the best one. Two of the best one, the Jackalope and Sushi, because they always do something. If they eat them, you can summon or they are really, really good. Two Mothman. It's good because if your opponent snipe it, you can still use the effect to gain one fusion or something like that. And then I play one Chupa because it's level 4, you can make an easy dweller. And I play two Bigfoot because it's the best one going second. You can push a lot of damage, so I prefer playing two. I don't like in general the bad dangers. For bad dangers, I mean these three and sometimes the Mothman, because in Mirror Match it's kinda useless, but it's needed, I think, because they are useful to make curious. For the Tiaramans, I play three Rhino because it's the best normal summon, or even with kit, it's very good. And you can make Dweller boosted by 500. Free Shine, free Avnis, and just two Meiru. Just two because, in my opinion, you don't need the third one, because in the standard line, you just summon it back with kit. You use this one to fusion, then bring it back with kit, and you don't need the third one. But it could be still an option for the future profiles, maybe. And I play this package with Beast because Winda is good in this format, and it's an aim for Curious because it's dark and you have another option than Rhino. So I like this engine. And just one Fairy Tail because it's standard in the combo. And it's the main target for Curious. For the spells, I play three, obviously, with Terraforming. One of these, mainly for mine. And one instant, best card of the deck, because it's an easy kit. And going second, I just play three of these and three Poly, because these are the best options going second, and against Blight, these cards are the most important. So you don't need a lot of flex spot in this format, just because in Mirror Match you don't really need it, and against Blight you just use this. And three of these, the best trap, because in my list you can set it back with the iPhone, and it's very useful if you mill or discard with dangers. For the extra deck, I play two kit and one of these. I decide to play two kit. I started just playing one, but I prefer to bring in the second one just because sometimes you need some, for example, against Mesh. One Garura, one of these, mainly for Super Poly, and this is an important target for the combo. You always summon this. Then Sustaviglia, I never summoned the second one, I think. Maybe one time, you for sure can cut one, because in this version you don't summon that often the second one. Okay, so
maybe the second one can you can
could be
make it's a grand game, but
yeah,
in this version you
don't open with Stabiga. It's very uncommon. One Winda because we play Beast, and we seeds, we play one well and one red over, standard lineup, because this is very important in Euro match, and with red over you can fusion in your opponent turn. So, kinda needed, and as link 2, I play just this. This is important just because it's another name with Curious, because it's Pekarse Dark, and this is very important because you can bring back the Nairu, so it's standard the combo. And then I play one this and one of these, just because I don't like the Bomber version, Bomber Dragon, because it's not that important in Mirror Match, and I think it's kinda weak in some spots, even against Blight. I prefer to summon this one because it guaranteed a follow up with the trap and with Nairu. And last one, Goddess. It's kinda important because you don't have out for Abramax or stuff like that, so I just need a flexible. Maybe you can play Mascherena
in the Arches future Code,
Arches Code, yeah. You can cut one of these, one depending on
how
the
many times market. You make the second kit.
Actually, I did it a lot, but if I know that I just play one, I make different combos. I mean, for example, sometimes I just leave it in the graveyard to make Stapel in my opponent's turn. Mm-hmm. Playing one, I just shuffle it back as soon as I can. Proceeding in the side, I play free Nib and the Gamma package, because I expected a lot of mirror match, and this actually is good against Danger, and the main problem in mirror match is Dweller, so I want a lot of outs. And I play free Barrier, because it's a good card when you go first. You can even set with Gryphon, so it's good. Speaking about Gryphon, I play one anti-spell for the same reason of Barrier. It's searchable, you can send by Curious and then set it back with Gryphon. And then I play one red reboot that I always side in every matchup going second, everyone. And then for the rogue decks, I play two Twin and one Eevee Duster. I just played against Blight and Tear, so maybe I could have cut this, but I mean, I was kinda scared about the mine.
Mm-hmm.
That's all. Want to text all my friends who helped with the list. The Gryphon is one of the most genius idea for this format, I think, because it's really good. And I want to text Giorgio, that supported me with the deck. He played the same deck, just with a few changes, and that's all.